Poema póstumo de Federico García Lorca. Canción de la muerte pequeña. Prado mortal de lunas y sangre bajo tierra. Prado de sangre vieja. Luz de ayer y mañana, cielo mortal de hierba, luz y noche de arena. Me encontré con la muerte. Prado mortal de tierra, una muerte pequeña. El perro en el tejado, solo a mi mano izquierda atravesaba montes sin fin de flores secas. Catedral de ceniza, luz y noche de arena, una muerte pequeña. Una muerte y yo un hombre solo y ella, una muerte pequeña. Prado mortal de luna, la nieve gime y tiembla por detrás de la puerta. Un hombre. ¿Y qué? Lo dicho. Un hombre solo y ella. Prado, amor, luz y arena.
Haltan deine Kinder und ihre Leiche. Es gibt nur meine Raumfall, um Gottes Willen!
There were investigations and there were stories and there were memoranda starting to be exposed, and the perfidy at the top and the systematic policy of changing the nation's tradition and its image in the world from a nation that wages a war in the name of freedom to a nation that actually practiced torture as a matter of state policy.
estamos decididos a aplicar la ley con firmeza inexorable.
Morón, Utrera, Puente Genil, Castro del Río, ¡id preparando sepulturas! Yo os autorizo a matar como un perro a cualquiera que se atreva a ejercer coacción ante vosotros. Que si lo hiciereis así, quedaréis extensos de toda responsabilidad. ¿Qué haré? Pues imponer un durísimo castigo para callar a esos idiotas congéneres de hazaña. Por ello faculto a todos los ciudadanos a que cuando se tropiecen a uno de esos sujetos lo callen de un tiro o me lo traigan a mí, que yo se lo pegaré. Nuestros valientes legionarios irregulares han enseñado a los cobardes de los rojos lo que significa ser hombre, y de paso también a las mujeres. Después de todo, estas comunistas y anarquistas se lo merecen. ¿No han estado jugando al amor libre? Ahora por lo menos sabrá lo que son hombres de verdad y no milicianos maricas. No se van a librar por mucho que forjecen y pataleen. Conocerán mi sistema. Por cada uno de orden que caiga, yo mataré a 10 extremistas por lo menos. Y a los dirigentes que huyan, no crean que se librarán con ello. Les sacaré de debajo de la tierra si hace falta, y si están muertos, los volveré a matar.
Along with mass incarceration, torture appears to be integral in the functioning of the world's most advanced state. It may not be accidental that the practice is often deployed in the special operations that have in many contexts replaced traditional warfare. The extension of counterterrorism operations to include assassination by unidentifiable mercenaries and remote control killing by the use of drones is part of this shift. Deaths on the battlefield have declined and may continue to decline. From one angle, this can be seen as an advancing condition of peace. From another point of view that looks at the variety and intensity with which violence is being employed, the long peace can be described as a condition of perpetual war.
Thank you. human civilization, however understood, is inherently fragile. And how do I make it real to you? Well, I'll make it real to you by mentioning an episode that I think every single person in this room will be old enough to have lived through, namely the rehabilitation of torture. By that I mean the policy which initially emerged to treat various forms of enhanced interrogation, as they were called, as legitimate methods or procedures or techniques in warfare and in interrogation, in questioning suspects, back in 2003 and onwards, in the context of the Iraq war. Now, until that actually happened, until Abu Ghraib and all those things came out, any suggestion that there could be a relaxation of the deeply rooted laws and procedures and conventions, national and international, governing torture of that kind, especially by the world's leading liberal democracy, was regarded as not just unlikely, but wildly, even cynically, misanthropically unrealistic. On the basis of what could be publicly known, and I knew nothing that was not publicly known, I only knew what was there to be known, I was certain that torture would be used on a large scale. Why was I certain of that? First of all, I also knew, because they were publicly public articles in well-known magazines by American writers who were close to the Bush administration, advocating the use of torture, advocating the legitimation of torture in the war against terror. So it didn't take joining that many dots to see what would happen. I was certain that torture would be used on a large scale, and it was. But the key point is not that this happened, it's that that possibility, until it happened, was regarded as wholly impossible, completely beyond the realm.
Su lona de pergamino preciosa tocando viene por un anfibio sendero de cristales y laureles. El silencio sin estrellas huyendo del sonsonete cae donde el mar bate y canta su noche llena de peces. En los picos de la sierra los carabineros duermen, guardando las blancas torres donde viven los ingleses. Y los gitanos del agua levantan por distraerse glorietas de caracolas y ramas de pino verde.